Wait a minute, baby. Don't leave just yet.
Hey, YouTube. Bloody, it's been a while. Sorry, I should have made another video after getting back from Chicago, but I've just been too busy. We're in our new house now, and we're finally getting settled in and finding a place for everything, and all that sort of jazz. So we're down in Brisbane now, down at the Big Smoke, and new house. So new house means new rules, so no smoking in the house. So all I can do is stare at my pipes instead of smoke them. So I'm gonna have to get myself one of those stupid ass vaping machines so I can blow smoke while I'm in here. So until then, I'll still get my coffee. Smoking pipes, which is absolutely filthy. I suppose I've had a few people ask me, so what did I get at the pipe show? Words got around. I went a little bit stupid, but I wasn't going to go all the way across to the States and not come back with something. So apart from getting a shitload of tins, which we had to send back, and I think we sent it back about 4 boxes. And it wasn't just all tobacco. We were gifted, when I say we, my wife, my kids and I, we got, who was it now? It was Northern Bohemian, Make and Change and AGS Mine 1, or Mark and Amber, better known as. They bombed our kids with a shit ton of candy, which was really cool. Some of which I've eaten. but the pipe show was just everything I could have wanted it to be. Not having anything here in Australia to compare it to, it just blows your mind as to the pipes that are there, the people that are there, the availability of tobacco to try. I mean, the second day we were in Chicago, I managed to come down with a sinus infection, so I couldn't smell or taste anything when it came to being at the show. So I think it was Boontar and Make and Change that they offered me some aged tobacco, and I had to refuse it because it was an absolute waste on me, because I couldn't have tasted it at all. Speaking of Boontar, we agreed that I'd wait until I got over there and he could give me my winnings from the last September's contest that he had around about the Nashville Pipe Show time. So I got crappy wads of tobacco and snus and stuff I wanted to try, so that was in lieu of a bag of stone even. So thanks again for that, Boontar. It's been fun going through that. I've enjoyed it. The snus is something different. If you don't have a good nicotine tolerance, you're gonna wear it. So that was really good. This is gonna be a bit of a talky long one, so you're not interested in that bit, sorry, you have to bear with me. I'm gonna show you a shit ton of pipes that I got at the show, in no particular order or preference or whatever else. Some were gifts, most I bought, some I pre-bought before I got there, and it's just easier to pick them up from people there. So we'll start off. What did I get first? First pipe I bought at the show was from Jesse Bone. It's a Canadian from a Canadian. I think I've shown this before in my last video. It's got a light sandblast, beautiful stem, nice and comfortable, smokes fantastically. Very, very fair price. If you, it's a good size smoke. If you are in the market for an artisan pipe, absolutely see Jesse. He's with the Heart and Pine Boys. If you haven't gotten around to finding that yet, Heart and Pine on YouTube and heartandpine.com, I think is their website. I'll put their information in the bucket below so you can go and click on their link and go to their web store and grab the stuff. I actually bought one of their belts that he and Tash make, and it's a fantastically made belt. Keeps some pants on my fat ass, so very good boys. So yeah, that was the first one. I think this was the first pipe he actually sold at the show, so that was an extra little thrill. Thanks very much, Jesse. Great pipe. One pipe I bought before the show, it's another artisan pipe maker, is doing a fantastic pipe job at the pipes. He's in the Pipe Guild, or the Pipe Carvers Guild. I think if you want to know anything about that, you can go to sparkingspipes.com, and there's a great big write up there about the Pipe Carvers Guild. This is a pipe maker by the name of Mike Couch. It's a blasted apple, I suppose you call it, bamboo. Hand cut vulcanite stem, a little bit of plateau on top. Fantastic smoking pipe, just absolutely love it. It's comfortable. I smoked the living hell out of this thing while I was at the show. I couldn't taste anything in it, but it still smoked really, really nice. So that was fantastic. So I actually saw this pipe in its very beginnings on Instagram, where it was just a block of briar, a piece of bamboo, and a vulcanite blank, and I saw the shape that he'd drawn out on the block, and I said that, I think we'd be grabbing that. Would you be interested in selling it before the show? And because this is a pipe that he actually had made for the show, and we found an arrangement, and picked it up off him at the show, and I will be a return customer of Mike's for sure. So grab a Mike Couch pipe. He is going to get very popular, and with popularity comes high prices. So get him while you can, I suppose. If you want to get a quality made pipe for not a lot of money, there's that one. Sparky pipes. There's a story behind this one. I've been given Sparky shit about a Diamond Shank Canadian for God knows how long. He finally gave in and made one. It wound up being a trade. I made him a backy flap out of Tasmanian oak, which actually was quite nice. I was tempted to keep that one myself. And he made me a Diamond Shank Canadian, and this actually has, I think it's mammoth tusk or elephant tusk. I can't ever remember which. Just a little bit of plateau at the front. This is another fantastic smoke. It is definitely not a clencher. It is a very, it's a tactile pipe, but it's got a good amount of meat on the bowl, so it's comfortable to hold. So that makes three Sparky. So I'm pretty honored to own one of those. So fantastic pipe off a fantastic guy. So that one. Before the show, before I even left the country, I was talking with Rick Farrell of Briarville Rick on Skype one night, and I mentioned that I bought a couple of Dunhills and I blame Legacy.UK for this. He's a bad influence. He's a bad man. Rick said, "Well, I'm taking some estate pipes to sell them." I said, "Oh yeah, what do you got?" And he said, "Would you like a private showing?" And I said, yeah, sure, no worries. He showed me No. Show me that one first. No, it was a Canadian. That's right. It's a Canadian. I think it's a 1976 root briar. Just, yeah, Dunhills. Okay, you either go with the hype or you don't. I don't prescribe to go with the hype. I got a Dunhill before I went to America, and I like how they smoke. They're a very well-made pipe. The old briar, I guess it just smokes, well, it seems like it smokes a whole lot nicer, actually, so, bug. So yeah, I got that one, and he coaxed me, he was teasing me, absolutely teasing me. He's a bastard, that man. He showed me this one, I just went, oh god, alright, I'll have that one too. And Rick Black can vouch for this because he was on Skype with us at the time too, so I totally blame Rick Farrah for the fact that I came home with, you know, two more Dunhills. So, but they are fantastic smoking pipes. They're both rib briars. That's a 76 and that's a 77. So I have a 75, a 76, and now a 77. So yeah, fantastic smoking pipes. Really, really nice. At the show, I ticked off some boxes. I got myself a really nice block mirror, and I really specifically wanted an eagle claw and egg. So I got this one. I've only lightly smoked it so far, so there's only a little bit of colour starting to happen in it, and I haven't waxed it yet. So, but there is a little bit of colour starting to happen on the underneath of the shank, but you just can't see because there's a light coming down on this way. But fantastic smoking pipe. I don't know who the maker is. I cannot make out the carver's initials. It looks like for all the world it could be Arabic, I don't know, but it looks like Triple J to me. But anyway, fantastic pipe, really, really nice smoking pipe. Another pipe I bought before I got to the States was Brandy from Paul's Pipes. Just natural finish, smooth, beautiful work, Paul, thank you very, very much. Fantastic pipe, love that one. Another pipe that I pre-bought before I went to the States and picked it up while I was over there, was a Stanwell Bulldog. I bought off Piping and Easy. You go to pipingandeasy.com. You'll find excellent estate pipes or unsmoked. I don't know why they call them unsmoked estate pipes. They're just pipes that are old that ain't been smoked yet. So anyway, fantastic little Bulldog. Really, really nice. It's a Stanwell Golden Danish. So, made in Denmark. Beautiful pipe. Found a guy dealing in Peterson's. Got a bit of a deal there. Two Petersons, they're both in the Iran finish. So that one is a 05 and that one is an XL02. Really, really nice smoking pipes. I like Petersons. A lot of people don't like them, I do. I got a shit ton of them now, and keeping in the same vein, while I was down in the Briar Patch in Sacramento, I found this one. It's a 408, it's a Rosalie. Really, really nice pipe. While I was at McNary's place, he foisted a couple of pipes on me. I don't know why, he's just a hell of a nice guy. He knows I've got a thing for Peterson, so we got a 999 Dracula and a 314 system pipe. So really, really cool pipes. So thank you, Jason. While I was at the show too, sorry, I'm gonna jump back and forth here, like I said, in no particular order. I sold a couple of backy japs and backy flaps to Gentleman Jim. I then turned around in one moment and saw Elaine. I said, I'll have that pipe, and bought one of his P2 billions. These are fantastic little pipes. If you haven't got one, you gotta get one. These are fantastic smoking pipes, they really are. Ticked off another box. Got a Gord Calabash. It's another pipe that if you want to collect pipes, you really need to get one of these. I've been smoking a Sutliff aromatic in this, and I kid you not, no word of a lie, no tongue bite, and I freight train that son of a bitch. It will, you just cannot get tongue bite from this pipe. I've yet to try it on Mac Baron's vanilla cream flake, yep, or vanilla cream ready rub. If I can smoke those two without getting tongue bite in this thing, I will be overjoyed. So so got this little stand for it as well. So brilliant. If you ever got a calabash, get a calabash. Okay, this is starting to get embarrassing. Went to see Chris Morgan, I went a little nuts there too. So I got a second Bright cigar. And because I already had one, there was a Diamond Shank Bulldog, his blackjack wine that I already had. So I thought, well, I'll complete the set. So there's the poker, the billiard, and the beer saver. I haven't smoked this one yet. I haven't smoked the billiard yet either. So, that's a big smoke. So, like I said, there's no point in showing tobacco. I mean, it's, you can see, I was gifted some, bought some, and yeah. So, all in all, I made out like a freaking bandit. And, two more that I've got. A couple of clays, and I'm surprised he's actually made them home in one piece, so, yeah. Great smoking pipes. If you want a really unadulterated tobacco flavour, smoke a clay. They actually smoke really nice. Gotta get some more of these at some point. So, they're not just for show. They smoke really well. It's off a German fella. I've got his card somewhere, and I'm damned if I can actually find them. So, if I ever do, I'll make a notation on this video on a later date. If you're interested in clays, then check back, and I may have something there for you. There was cigars and drinking and the beer and baccy show. That was fantastic. It was just awesome to meet them, you know, all those YouTubers and people I've Skyped with for the last couple of years, and you know, watched on YouTube at these events, and I could finally be a part of it, and I will be coming back at some point. I don't know when, but before I shake the mortal coil, I'm going to see another one of these events. There ain't anything going to ever happen in Australia like that, whether it be Chicago, Nashville, Vegas, or Ohio. It's just won't ever happen here like that. So, oh well. But I had a blast meeting everyone. I really did. I love shaking hands with everyone, and hugs and back slaps and photos and peace signs and all this sort of shit. It was just so much fun. I didn't want to come home. Sunday night at the show was really hard because I knew I had to get up early the next morning and catch a flight out to Sacramento to go out to Jason McNary's place. And I think I whispered to him at one point, get me out of here, because I didn't want to go. There was tears and bullshit. It was really, really good. And I can't call out everybody's name because I'm going to forget someone, and I don't want to do that. I mean this sincerely. You go to these things, it happens. You know, you get this sense of family and this. It's just how it is. It's unexplainable. It really is. To any of the other Aussies watching this, if you can get over there at all, make yourself known to these guys, and when you get over there, just say, hey, I'm such and such, I'm from Australia, I'll say hang out, come and have a smoke, come and have a beer, and you wind up making friends for life. It's quite an experience. So It was good. It was really, really good. But anyway, I have rambled on long enough. Hopefully now that we're all settled in and whatnot, I can start making a few more videos. When I've got my lathe up and running, I'll start doing a few more videos down there. And yeah, we'll be back on the lathe pretty shortly. So, you know, things like, you know, backy flaps will be coming out. Hawaiian Piper Josh. I'm literally just a couple of days away from getting my lathe up and running. So I'll have your prize out to you shortly, probably within the next 2 weeks. So, I mean, I did say, you know, late June, mid-July, so it just takes time to get things unpacked, and because my lathe's been sitting there for a month or so, and it's rusted to hell, and I'm going to clean it up and grease it up and all this sort of fun shit. So, but yeah, I'll be on it pretty soon. I'm starting to miss the turning myself. So, anyway, guys, take it easy. Cheers.
If you're sick, feeling low.